My name is Stanislaw Roberto with AV Ultra. This is a three-part tutorial series. In our first part, we're going to be taking a look at creating a lower third from scratch, and that is just a plain basic title bar. In our second part, we're going to be designing a more exciting lower third, something that you'd probably want to be using a little bit more. And then in our third one, we're going to be animating our lower third. So if you feel comfortable with After Effects, I would jump right to that third part. And if you are brand new to lower thirds, let's start with number one. Now, you can make lower thirds in other programs as well too, but we're going to focus on After Effects for today. All right, so let's go ahead and get started. So let's talk about exactly what a lower third is. Typically, on the news or on TV during shows, whenever you're introducing someone or some other information that you don't really want to take away from the story to introduce someone, you'll just put in a lower third title bar. So you can think of it as a title or just something to give us more information about what we're looking at without having to pull away from the story to explain it. We're going to go ahead and get started from scratch. So I have a piece of footage here in my project file, and I'm just going to drag this and create a new comp from it. It is 1920 by 1080, and you can see it is just a small beach scene here. I'm going to go ahead and make that fit my screen here. And it's playing back fine, and if you saw this, you would just be like, okay, great, that's a beach scene. But what I want to do is I want to give myself a little bit of a title here that has a bit of transparency at the end, so it doesn't take up the whole screen. I want it to kind of fade off there. And I'm just going to change this down to maybe half resolution, just so that way it plays back a little bit quicker. All right, so let's go ahead and get started. So the first thing I'm going to do is go up and grab my shape tools here. Now, I want this nice rectangular shape. I can also hit the letter Q to kind of cycle through these, and as I'm hitting that, you can see that it is changing there. Again, that is the letter Q. And I'm just going to make sure I'm in my rectangle. And I'm just going to draw a shape out. So we're just going to draw this. All right. And there is my rectangle. In fact, there's my shape layer. And you can see that under its contents, it says rectangle. Great. Now, I have a couple things to consider when I'm putting my lower thirds together. One is placement. And that is exactly where on my screen it's going to be. One of the reasons why they call it a lower third is because it usually takes up the lower third of our screen here. If it was up here, it would be more like a title. And if it would be here, it would be really in the way. All right, so I want mine towards the bottom here. I could have this kind of take up this whole section down here. I think that's a little too much for my personal taste. So I'm just going to go ahead. I'm grabbing the handles here. And I'm just going to drag it right to here. All right, so I want to create that gradient I was talking about here. And as soon as I've created a shape here, you'll notice I have a couple shape options. So I have a fill color and a stroke color. Now, my fill color right now is set to solid. And if I click on this color, it just brings up my color bar. And I can change this to whatever color I'd like. I'm going to keep this pretty black here. And if I want to change the kind of fill this is, I'm actually going to click on my fill options here. So if I actually click on the word fill, that's going to open up this panel here, which is my fill options. And I have some different options here. One, I have no fill. And what that's going to do is just give me a stroke if I have any kind of stroke width to there. So as an example here, if I change this to, let's say, 5, and I click off of there, you can see there is a stroke outline, and that stroke has a bit of a gradient to it. And I'm just going to turn that back down to 0. And I'm going to go ahead and click on my shape again and go to my fill options. So under my fill options here, I've got my none for my fill. We took a look at that, my solid color, and that's going to do that. And then I also have my linear and my radial. So this first one here is my linear. And then this next one here would be my radial. I'm just going to stick with my linear right now and hit OK. And right away you can see this is getting closer to what we want, but not quite exactly. So if I click on my shape layer down here, you'll notice I get my shape here. And if I click on my colors here, well, now I have a different kind of panel than I had with my solid. I have two bars here. This first one here is my color stops, and this top one here is my opacity stops. So what this basically means is if I drag this from here to here, right, I'm going to hit OK, and if I change this opacity stop, you can see as soon as I've clicked that, I can drag this opacity down to 0%. That means from here, where it is 100%, to here, it is going to fade off right at this midpoint. And if I drag this over here, you can kind of see how that's filling in a little bit more, where I can pull that back and kind of soften those edges. It's almost like a feathered edge. You'll also notice that I have this little handle here. This handle is really where my gradient begins and ends. So if I drag one of these here, right, we can kind of see what that's doing. And now, very quickly and easily, I can kind of drag out where my colors begin or end. What exactly is this doing? Well, if I go to my gradient fill here, I just twirl this down, I have my start point and my end point. And you can see how that's changing where that line is. So if I take it to something like this, pull this back, I can really nuance where this begins and ends. Oops, grab my whole thing here. And I'm just grabbing this little gradient handle. Now, if I want to adjust how far over this gradient happens, well, I'm going to go back to that fill and just pull this over a little bit, right? And maybe I don't want this exactly to be 100% there. I can just drag that over. So now I've got this really soft gradient going across here. And if I unclick that, you can kind of see what's happening there. It's kind of fading off. In fact, let's finesse that just a little bit more. I'm going to click back on there. And we're just going to pull this back a little bit and take this opacity stop and pull that back just a little bit here too. So that way it's 100% clear right here. In fact, if I turn off this layer here and I turn on my transparency, we can kind of see exactly how that's filling out. All right, so that's perfect. The only other thing I want here now is my actual title. I'm going to go to my horizontal type tool or hit Command T, and that's going to let me click and drag an area for my title. So I'm just putting a box in there, and this will house my title. I'm using a Myriad Pro at 76 pixels. Now, if I want to make a subtitle, I can do the same thing and just draw out another one. I'm just going to hit Command D on my layer here. And there's my title too. And I'm just going to call this one Subtitle. I'm just hitting Return to rename it. I'm going to drag that underneath my title. And we're going to pull this down right down here. And I'm just going to change that size because typically subtitles are going to be a bit smaller. I filmed this on Rocky Island, a nice little tiny island I stayed at in the middle of summer here to do some nighttime time-lapse photography. So I'm going to call this one here Rocky Island. And this was located on the Apostle Islands. So there we go. If I want to fade this in and fade this out as one whole thing, I'm going to take everything that is included in my subtitle here. So there's my title, my subtitle. In fact, let me rename that here because it named it here. Title, subtitle, and shape layer. I'm going to take all three of those. I'm going to right click and pre-compose. And I'm just going to call this one lower third. So now there I go. I've got a one solid title here that I can kind of turn on and off at any time. And I'm just going to hit the letter T to change my opacity. And we're going to have this fade in at 1 second. So I'm going to about 1 second here. In fact, let's go exact 1.00, 1 second. And I'm going to hit my stopwatch to make a keyframe. And I'm going to go to 0 seconds, 0 frames, and change my value here to 0% for my opacity. So between 0 frames and my 30 frame here, my 1 second, you'll see that it fades on, and then it's going to stay on until about 9 seconds here, where I'm going to make another keyframe, just clicking right here, and go to the end and hit 0%. So there you go. Really quick, easy way to make a very simple lower third. That will get us by in a pinch. To be honest, it's okay. I think that it's a little boring and we can do a little bit better. So let's take a look at creating a more dynamic lower third.